It is Pride Month, and so a lot of corporations and groups, including sporting teams, want to show their pride by generally like changing their avatar on Twitter or something, but sometimes even changing their uniforms. And the Tampa Bay Rays wanted to do this. They had special jerseys and caps with a rainbow colored logo. The idea was going to be that all the players would sport that new uniform. Five Rays pitchers apparently opted out. Jason Adams, Jalen Beeks, Brooks Raley, Jeffrey Springs, and Ryan Thompson peeled off the special logos, with Jason Adams explaining his thought process, saying, "When we put it on our bodies, I think a lot of guys decided that it's just a lifestyle, that maybe, not that they look down on anybody or think differently, it's just that maybe we don't want to encourage it if we believe in Jesus, who's encouraged us to live a lifestyle that would abstain from that behavior, just like Jesus encouraged me as a heterosexual male to abstain from sex outside of the confines of marriage." And as we debate this, you can see in this tweet from the Rays what the logo would actually look like, and it actually looks pretty cool, I think. In any event, Jessica, what do you think about the fact that these players decided to strip off the special logos?
You know, as a queer person, I think it's funny to imagine them getting to the gates of heaven and Jesus is like, "You know, you wore a rainbow in the game against the Cardinals, therefore no entry." It's absurd. Mm. It's absurd to think that this matters or that Jesus cares, honestly.
My overall impression of this is, I think, yeah, they shouldn't have to wear a logo that doesn't, like, if they want to identify themselves as the only players on the team that are making a relatively active effort to make people feel not included or accepted or loved or respected, I think that it should be their right to do so. They can identify themselves that way. I don't actually have a problem with that. I don't think that they should be disciplined or anything. But it is, like, to your point, the idea that Jesus would be like, you could have made people feel bad and you didn't, and thus now you're cast into a lake of fire. Like, why you would do that? And I know that they're not going as far as that with their religious stuff, but it's about making people feel like accepted. And like, I got news for them, like, queer people of all different types have been around in this and every society for as long as there have been societies. And it is so universal that you have to assume that if you think any divine being created the universe, that they created that. They certainly haven't done anything across all these societies, across all this time. Like, so I don't know. And when you actually jump into the Bible, what the Bible actually has to say about any of this is so incongruent with the like current right-wing evangelical approach to these issues that I just find this to be so needless.
Especially when we consider DeSantis really being upset with the Rays right now for their joint statement about gun violence and saying that they're not going to give them, DeSantis saying the government's not going to give them funding for a training facility because of this statement, but also because, you know, government funding shouldn't support political activism. But then he makes it about government funding shouldn't go to corporations. We're back to the same argument when it came to Disney, because he's trying to avoid getting in trouble with violating the First Amendment. But it's very interesting that the Rays are making these stances. The players don't really agree with this one, but we didn't really see a lot of pushback for the statement about gun violence. But I mean, most members of the queer community don't really see corporations as, you know, the vessel for their rights and acceptance in society anyway. But it is absurd that they feel that they have to remove this thing from their jerseys.
Yeah, absurd, absurd. Like, we're not going, like, this isn't cancel culture. I'm not, at least I don't think you are calling for them to be fired or benched over it or whatever. I believe if you want to demonstrate support for something, you can do it and you shouldn't be punished for that, kneeling, for instance. And if you don't want to, if that's how you want to identify yourself, I think it's perfectly fine too. I mean, not morally fine. I think there's something wrong with you, that you have an issue with this community. I think there's something fundamentally deeply wrong and broken with you, but I don't think you should be fired as a result of the fact that you are morally broken in this particular way.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.